Thank you. Right side of our train, where he will catch a rocky embankment. Now that embankment is lined with limestone, although many people do take it for granted. That truly is one of the boulder sites along our route. If you were to pick out the largest piece of limestone on that rock, or on that ridge, you could call it Dwayne the Rock Johnson. I promise this is the last fun about rocks. If you were to climb to the top of that ridge, you would truly be on Rocky Top. We have completed our shove around the east leg of our Y. We can now proceed down the west leg and begin our westbound journey to Grand Junction, east to Chattanooga. We're currently riding on one of the first railroads into Chattanooga, being completed in 1858 by the East Tennessee, Virginia, and Georgia Railroad. The ETVG merged with a number of other railroads over time to eventually become the famous Southern Railway in 1894. The Southern Railway will continue to use this very line up until the mid-1950s. But they would abandon it for reasons I'll explain later in our journey. A new line would be constructed just to the north, which you all saw up on the embankment behind Grand Junction Station. That new line is today operated on by the Southern Railway's successor, the Norfolk Southern Corporation. Of course, the Southern Railway would donate these 3 miles of track to hit the Tennessee Valley Railroad Museum, which we have been operating on ever since. Of course, we are only joking. We'll be back in about a year. Again, joking. We'll be back in about 55 minutes, folks. Now, the line we're on today is not the original 1859 right-of-way of the East Tennessee, Virginia, and Georgia Railroad. That original right-of-way lies just to the left of our train now, today marked by a gravel road. The line was elevated to its current height and position in the early decades of the 20th century due to numerous occasions of flooding. As an example of that flooding, in just a few moments to the left of our train, you will see a sign, South Chickamauga Creek. If the water's blowing, it's possible turtles, river otters, geese, or my personal favorite for the day, muddy water. To the left of our train, you'll see a set of stone piers. Those stone piers mark the site of the original bridge. Other than a wood decking that the rails would have run on, that bridge was constructed entirely of stone. It was unfortunately washed away in a great flood. At the time of that washout, there was a train coming. Great Locomotive Chase. Those of you that haven't heard of it, the Great Locomotive Chase is the story of James Andrews and 23 others known as Andrews Raiders. Their plans were quite simple. They then raced the General all the way north to Chattanooga, while burning bridges and destroying track and telegraph wires in an effort to sever the crucial Confederate supply artery. All was going according to plan for Andrews Raiders until they saw black smoke rising behind them. At first, they believed it was a bridge they had just attempted to burn. That is, up until they heard a whistle. Blowing that whistle was the General's conductor, William Fuller. He first pursued his locomotive on foot, then by hand car, a succession of locomotives, and finally in the famous locomotive he commandeered, named the Texas. Now, when Conductor Fuller would take the Texas, it was facing south. So for the duration of the chase, he would have to run his locomotive in reverse. Luckily enough for him, the General would run out of fuel just north of Ringgold, Georgia, about 18 miles down the track from Chattanooga. track, while the rest of the line was double track, creating a major bottleneck. A new line would be constructed just to the north, which you all saw up on the embankment behind Grand Junction Station. That new line bypasses Missionary Ridge altogether. Now if you have a flashlight app on your cell phone, I do encourage you to have those out at this time to illuminate the tunnel walls as we pass through them. At times there is less than a foot of clearance between us and these tunnel walls, so good thing we don't have any open windows. If your window is open, please do see a member of our staff, as they are not designed to do so. Of Missionary Ridge. Yes. Inside East Chattanooga Depot, we do have ice cream, drinks, and snacks available, as well as restrooms. Once you get on the train, the depot will be to your right, the turntable will be to your left. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please do remain seated until we come to a complete stop. We'll let you know when it is safe to enter the exit.
Got a mobile plane.
Like I mentioned a few moments ago, the 45 over, this turntable is 80 feet long. The 4501 here is approximately 85 feet in length. So there's about 2.5 feet of overhang on each side of our turntable. That's why we do ask everybody to please remain well behind that safety line, yellow safety line you see painted on the ground in front of you. Your locomotive today is Southern Railway number 4501. It was built in 1911 by the Baldwin Locomotive Works in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. It was built for use on the Southern Railway as a freight locomotive. It is an MS-1 class Mikado steam locomotive. Now, I know what you're thinking. What does Mikado mean? Well, Mikado refers to its wheel arrangement. And Mikado is a 282 class steam locomotive. To the front of the locomotive, there are two small pilot wheels. We have 8 large driving wheels here in the center, and 2 small trailing wheels just behind me here under the cab. Now, like I said, this locomotive was built for use on the Southern Railway in 1911, and it has a pretty interesting life on the Southern. On the Southern Railway, we have short trailing plans, freight trains. In 1948, the Southern Railway was completely dieselized, purchasing brand new locomotives, or diesel locomotives, replacing steam locomotives like the 4501 here. The 4501 would be saved by a small branch, or a small short line railroad named the Kentucky and Tennessee Railway. They purchased it in 1948. And in 1964, even the Kentucky and Tennessee would end up dieselizing. That's where the Tennessee Valley Railroad Museum comes into the story of the 4501. One of our founders, Mr. Paul Merriman, would go to the Kentucky and Tennessee Railway with a check for $5,000, and then he would purchase it for the Tennessee Valley Railroad Museum. We've had this locomotive since 1964, and came to Chattanooga under its own power. We've been operating this locomotive off and on since we got it in 1964. Its most recent overhaul was in 2014. Now folks, there is a couple of guys I'd like to point out to you on this locomotive. Over on that other side of the cab, you'll see your firemen, Tim and Zach. Over on this side of the locomotive, you didn't really get to see him, but that was your engineer, Travis. We couldn't do it without any of them, so everybody please give them a round of applause. Now, even if you've never visited with us here at the Tennessee Valley Railroad Museum, you've probably seen some of our equipment before in the past. We're very often involved in Hollywood films and music videos. The 4501 here has been one of our main stars. It's been involved in the making of films such as October the Sky, Fool's Parade, and a television series by Johnny Cash called Riding the Rail. Johnny Cash actually ran this locomotive in his television program. We must now line our locomotive up with track 2, while our train sits on track 1. We'll then reverse back through that switch and recouple to the other end of our train. So what was the front is now the back and vice versa. car or locomotive, but they will pick up one of these for that. People are used to pick up these large equipment, such as the 1877 behind me. So those yellows out of the way, we can now get you the excuse me, some equipment we have in the shop.
Thank you. locomotive, it's got two small wheels. You got an inner and a rear curve, eight large driving wheels to actually power the train, and no wheels under the cabin firebox area. This time I'd like to ask that everyone please remain behind the yellow line at all times.
Thank you. Dawes, 4 o'clock.
It was like the whole place was traveling.
Thank you.
No, he did.
He wouldn't let you blow it?
No. Oh, that must be the main line. Look. I thought that's what it was, Canadian National. Canadian National engine. I'm going.
They might be fixing up some of these.
I could be.